It's the players' one night of the year. The night in which the umpires reward the player deemed the fairest and most brilliant in South Australian league football. Tonight, live from Football Park, we present the Magarey Medal 2000. Ladies and gentlemen, your host for tonight, Stephen Trigg.
Good evening. Well, the record books show that you have to go a long way back to 1972 to find Woodville's only, yes, only Magarey medalist in Malcolm Blight, and even further to 63 to find one for West Torrens. And since those two clubs have amalgamated nearly 10 years ago, the Eagles are yet to produce one. But wherever you go and whoever you talk to in footy circles at the moment, they'll tell you just one thing, and that is, it's all about to change.
With the Eagles soaring in 2000, could it be Gavin Colville, the tough midfielder and bookie's favourite for the medal? What about Justin Sigalella, the skillful and evasive rover who polled third in 99? Andrew Beveridge, the Eagles' tough and tireless rover. Will he take the medal back home to Woodville? Bruce Lennon, Sturt's talented and hard-running centreman. Could he make it two in a row for the Double Blues? Philip McGuinness, the Magpies rover. Will he finally catch the umpire's eye with his great goal sense and high possession game? And Trent Mills, the courageous vice-captain and key player for the Panthers. Could this be the year he takes the medal back down to Nalunga? Who will it be?
My tip for the Magarey would have to be Gavin Colville because of his red hair.
Gavin Colville. It would probably be Gavin Colville.
Gavin Colville from the Eagles.
Well, I've seen the Eagles, so Andrew Beveridge or Jamie Tope.
Colville from the Eagles and Bruce Lennon from Sturt.
Gavin Colville would be favourite for the medal.
Gavin Colville seems to have had a pretty good year, but maybe a smoky from our club might be David Morgan.
Who will wear the Magarey medal in the year 2000?
Pretty consistent theme, isn't it? And we wish Gavin all the very best with that heavy burden of carrying the raging favourite at 8-10. Well, let's go straight to the count, and I'd like to introduce the President and the Chief Executive of the SANFL. Together, they've accumulated, well, around about 40 years at the top of the tree in the SANFL. They've presided over the tough decisions, the big issues, and just about always come up trumps. Would you please welcome Lee Wicker, the Chief Executive, and the President himself in that customary role, Max Bashir.
Thank you, Stephen. Your Excellency, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Magarey Medal telecast. I hope that you'll all have an enjoyable evening. I must remind you that players who've been found guilty of a breach of the laws of the game are not eligible to win the medal. I will now proceed with the count. Round one, Port Adelaide versus Woodville West Torrens. Eagles, Adam Pearce, one vote. Eagles, Andrew Rogers, two votes. Port Adelaide, Brett Chalmers, three votes. Norwood versus West Adelaide. West Adelaide, Benjamin Marsh, one vote. Norwood, Benjamin Wilson, two votes. Norwood, Anthony Harvey, three votes. Sturt versus Central District. Central District, Brent Guerra, one vote. Sturt, Brodie Atkinson, two votes. Central District, Jared Schofield, three votes. South Adelaide versus North Adelaide. North Adelaide, Scott Sutherland, one vote. South Adelaide, Trent Mills, two votes. North Adelaide, Benjamin Setchell, three votes. in round two, Central District versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Stephen Brosnan, one vote. Port Adelaide, Philip McGuinness, two votes. Port Adelaide, Brett Chalmers, three votes. Glenelg versus North Adelaide. North Adelaide, Lucas Herbert, one vote. Glenelg, Benjamin Moore, two votes. And Glenelg, Nick Chigwidden, three votes. West Adelaide versus South Adelaide. South Adelaide, Simon Crawshay, one vote. South Adelaide, Ian Perry, two votes. And South Adelaide, Trent Mills, three votes. Woodville, West Torrens versus Sturt. Eagles, Adam Ugrinic, one vote. Sturt, Damian Squire, two votes. And Eagles, Gavin Colville, three votes. In round three, Norwood versus Glenelg. Norwood, Robert Neal, one vote. Norwood, Andrew Eccles, two votes. Norwood, Scott Borlase, three votes. Port Adelaide versus West Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Paul Vines, one vote. Port Adelaide, Brett Chalmers, two votes. And Port Adelaide, Mark Clayton, three votes. Sturt versus North Adelaide. North Adelaide, Scott Stevens, one vote. North Adelaide, Scott Bamford, two votes. And North Adelaide, Scott Sutherland, three votes. In round four, Woodville West Torrens versus Norwood. Eagles, Rhett Biglands, one vote. Eagles, Jamie Tate, two votes. And Eagles, Andrew Beveridge, three votes. Port Adelaide versus South Adelaide. South Adelaide, Trent Mills, one vote. Port Adelaide, Mark Clayton, two votes. And Port Adelaide, Stephen Carter, three votes. North Adelaide versus West Adelaide. North Adelaide, Mark Jeffries, one vote. West Adelaide, Jamie Andriski, two votes. And West Adelaide, Benjamin Marsh, three votes. Glenelg versus Central District. Central District, Rick McGowan, one vote. Glenelg, James Byrne, two votes. And Central District, Marco Bello, three votes. And that completes round four.
All fine weather football there, but there was a remarkable day in the middle of June when the Eagles and South Adelaide went head-to-head at Noarlunga. It was one of those remarkable days of footy that they played in ankle-deep water. You'll see a touch of that in just a moment. One player who played very, very well in the swimathon, in fact, he played very well all year, was the Panthers' Trent Mills.
My form probably has been a little bit like the team's form. We started reasonably well and had a reasonable spot in the middle, but sort of tailed away a little bit at the end. probably play my best football in the midfield. I don't mind trying to sneak down and kick a few goals occasionally as well. Probably one of my strengths is being able to read the play and get to the right positions and read the ball off packs and stuff.
Certainly a very smooth mover, isn't he? And reads the ball well off the packs, gets plenty of possessions as a result, and you'd think would be a pretty good show tonight. Well, a player who's very, very similar in style when you think back is our own, ABC's own, that is, 1991 Magarey medalist Mark Nailey. Very similar style. And Nails has jumped onto his bike tonight. He's gone down to the old South Adelaide clubrooms. And Mark, some of your thoughts, I suppose, going back 9 years. A little bit of nervousness, I imagine. What are the memories like?
Yes, Stephen, just going back then, I mean, that was 9 years ago, and you just sort of, you know, back then you didn't really play for those individual awards. I think back then, you know, it was a pretty exciting night at the Hindley Park Royal, but I think the importance about the Magarey medal is after you sort of retire, and you sort of look back and people in the street sort of recognise you as being a Magarey medalist, and that's what I reckon really does think in then. But tonight, I mean, there's a few other Panther players down there tonight just looking for their first Magarey medal. I mean, South Adelaide had won two in the 90s, but I've only seen about three or four of their games this year. But one of the person here with me tonight is their assistant coach, and Johnny Griffin. And John, just a few of the South players this year that might poll pretty well, and maybe a few of your dark horses from the other clubs.
Yeah, I think the big Crabby will do well tonight. He's had a very consistent year. He probably had his worst game against Sturt, and he'd be disappointed in that. Millsy, scratcher around the middle. I think Dean Talbot's been very consistent, and I think a few of the boys have said a dark horse is Johnny Hassel, but I think Johnny Hassel's the only bloke I've ever seen give away a 120-metre penalty in a game of footy, so he's probably saying the wrong thing to the umpires, but there's the boys around the middle will do well. A few from the others that I've been very, very impressed with is obviously Colville, but also Squire. I would say he'd be sitting by himself tonight because no one's been on him for the last month or anywhere near him, and I've been very impressed with him. And a few of the smalls, I think Bello has impressed me, and Hollands has impressed me as well, and I think Brucey Lennon. But I think it should come from the blokes that are quiet and tell the umpires the right things and the things that those people that are not quite human want to hear. So the nice guys in footy.
Well, Stephen, as you can hear, there's a very small crowd down here tonight. There's a few players that have come down here just, you know, really to lend their support, and there's a couple of supporters down here as well. I mean, we're looking forward for a good night. I just hope it's the best for you.
Yes, thank you very much to Mark and to John. Crabby, by the way, is Simon Crawshay, just to decipher some of that for you. And John, wouldn't matter if it was windy down there, would it? You just wouldn't notice with Johnny. Now, the McCullum Medal is presented each and every year for the under-17s. Thank you, just a little bit of catch-up. The under-17s is awarded each and every year with the McCullum Medal. And to make the presentation live on stage tonight, here's David Mackay.
Thank you, Stephen. With me is Barry Robren, triple Magarey medalist, and he's here to present the medal to Wade Harrison from North Adelaide, the under-17 McCullum Medal. Congratulations, Wade. Started with Northfield, then Jepps Cross. It's been an interesting journey for you, just a young career. Now, you're nervous?
Yeah, actually.
Well, don't be, I'll look after you. Now, David Tiller's your coach. He must look after you.
Yeah, he does. He's a pretty good coach. I mean, he's played a few games as well, so yeah, he knows what he's talking about.
Now, you only played 17 games. You polled six best on grounds and 2 seconds, no thirds. From just 8 games polled, you won the medal pretty convincingly. Congratulations.
Yeah, excellent.
Is there anyone you'd like to thank?
I just like to thank my parents, all my teammates and my coach, thanks.
Yeah. Terrific. Ladies and gentlemen, would you put your hands together for Wade Harrison, the North Adelaide under-17 McCullum medalist. Thank you.
Well done, David. One of the, no doubt, one of the easier interviews you've had, and Wade, 6 best on ground performances from him, a really wonderful effort. Well, you'd think, wouldn't you think, that the player with the most possessions in the competition would give the Magarey medal a fair old shake. That player with 500 possessions this year is Phil McGuinness.
McGuinness gets those thumping thighs moving.
I think coming to the Port Adelaide Football Club was probably the best break in my footy career. I've learned a lot since I've been here. enjoy playing my footy around the midfield, and it's expected of us to kick a few goals when we're in the pocket. Yeah, I think one of my main strengths is goal kicking. I like to kick a few goals.
He's a really good player, Phil McGuinness, but last year he was a favourite as well and he polled just one vote, so hopefully he'll have a little bit of better luck tonight. Let's go back to the count now, rounds 5-8.
In round 5, North Adelaide versus Woodville West Torrens, Eagles, Andrew Beveridge, one vote. Eagles, John Floriani, two votes. Eagles, Jamie Tape, three votes. Sturt versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Tom Carr, one vote. Sturt, Bruce Lennon, two votes. And Sturt, Andrew Geddes, three votes. Central District versus Norwood. Central District, Daniel Stevens, one vote. Central District, Stuart Dew, two votes. And Central District, Rick McGowan, three votes. South Adelaide versus Glenelg. South Adelaide, Dean Talbot, one vote. South Adelaide, Ian Perry, two votes. And South Adelaide, Mark DeMarzi, three votes. In round 6, Sturt versus South Adelaide. South Adelaide, Christopher Hall, one vote. Sturt, Daniel Wicks, two votes. And Sturt, Damian Squire, three votes. Woodville West Torrens versus Central District. Central District, Jeremy Ofterheide, one vote. Central District, Daniel Holm, two votes. And Central District, Daniel Healy, three votes. West Adelaide versus Glenelg. West Adelaide, Matthew Connell, one vote. West Adelaide, Adam Richardson, two votes. Glenelg, Martin Melody, three votes. Norwood versus North Adelaide. North Adelaide, Lucas Herbert, one vote. North Adelaide, Scott Sutherland, two votes. North Adelaide, Daniel Morton, three votes. In round 7, Port Adelaide versus Glenelg. Shane Tipper-Mantemary, one vote. Port Adelaide, Mark Clayton, two votes. And Port Adelaide, Ricky O'Loughlin, three votes. Woodville West Torrens versus South Adelaide. Woodville West Torrens, Gavin Colville, one vote. South Adelaide, Nathan Turvey, two votes. And South Adelaide, David Morgan, three votes. Central District versus West Adelaide. Central District, Marco Bello, one vote. Central District, Daniel Stevens, two votes. And Central District, Stuart Dew, three votes. Norwood versus Sturt. Sturt, Brody Atkinson, one vote. Norwood, Dale Fleming, two votes. And Norwood, Andrew Pascoe, three votes. In round 8, West Adelaide versus Woodville West Torrens, Eagles, Matthew Manfield, one vote. Eagles, Justin Sicalella, two votes. And Eagles, Gavin Colville, three votes. North Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Ricky O'Loughlin, one vote. Port Adelaide, Darren Fraser, two votes. And Port Adelaide, Paul Vines, three votes. South Adelaide versus Norwood. Norwood, Matthew Dawes, one vote. South Adelaide, Derek Murray, two votes. And South Adelaide, Dean Talbot, three votes. Glenelg versus Sturt. Glenelg, Matthew Golding, one vote. Glenelg, Martin Melody, two votes. And Glenelg, Nick Chigwidden, three votes, and that completes round eight.
Fairly fashionable to celebrate a goal, isn't it? Any which way you possibly can. Now, the Eagles this year have had many, many good players, as you could imagine, in finishing emphatically as minor premiers. One of those players was recruited specifically from Tasmania just to bolster the midfield. His name, Andrew Beveridge.
This year I've played in the centre mainly. And I think that suited my style of play, and it's fitted in more so really well with the team. I just go about trying to get the football and trying to bring other players into the game. Initially at the start of the season I had a few umpires, I think they were a bit concerned with maybe some unduly rough play. I hope I haven't attracted them for the wrong reason.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Andrew Beveridge, one of our great champions in the SNFL this year. Well, it's also under 19 Tompkins medal time, and with me is the 75 Magarey medalist Peter Woit to present the medal from Port Adelaide. Ben, congratulations, great year. We looked at your 15 games and six best on grounds, one second, one first. It must have been a tremendous season.
Oh, actually, I felt a little bit disappointed with my season. I was hoping to play a few more Resi's games this year, but lost a bit of form early in the season and was just happy to go back and play well in the 19s.
We did play two reserves games and got one vote in that as well. So Neville Tierley, I guess your under 19 coach, must have been pretty happy with your progress.
Oh, he's always a happy bloke, but he likes to turn pretty quick on people, I suppose. That's how he eggs people on, gets them going. Likes to have a bit of a spit, but he's a great bloke, good coach.
Now, I know your dad, Bob, really has followed your career pretty well. He's very proud of you as well. Is there anyone you'd like to thank?
Definitely I'd like to thank the Port Adelaide Football Club. Mum and Dad, they're always there behind me, you know, striving, telling me to do my best. But one person I think I really have to thank is Mr. David Hart. He's always been behind me and gives me a lot of helpful advice. He was one of my junior coaches, so I think I really have to say a big thank you to him.
Well done to Ben Wilcox, the under 19 Tompkins medalist from Port Adelaide. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen.
And good luck to Ben as he moves into senior footy next year. Now, patrolling the boundary line through the year has been ex-Rooster and 1987 Jack Odie medalist, all 201 centimetres of him, Michael Parsons. He's ventured to Oval Avenue
yes,
tonight.
Yes, thank you very much. And it has certainly been a stellar season for both the Eagles and several individuals. And that could be their only problem for this crowd here tonight. And a fair few of them have come in to enjoy a little dinner and watch the count. But with me, the development manager of the Eagles, Ben. And Ben, there must be a few players out there that you'd rate a chance.
Oh, there's definitely a few chances. I think the key to our success this year has been the fact that we've had 21 contributors each week. So I think they probably will rob a few votes off each other.
And Gavin's obviously a favourite, but who else do you think may poll pretty well from the Eagles?
Obviously Jamie Tape and Andrew Beveridge, and I think Nick Pesch might even take a few votes.
And if it doesn't come from the Eagles, who do you see as a dark horse from maybe another club?
Probably Lennon from Sturt, I think.
Fantastic. And also with me, one of the true believers down here at the Eagles, that's Vera Appleby. Vera, who is your favourite player?
Gavin Colville.
Do you think he's going to get enough votes to win tonight?
I hope so, unless some of the other players take the votes from him.
Fantastic, Vera. And I think everybody else down here hopes that he'll get enough votes to win as well. Thank you, Stephen.
Yes, thank you, Michael. And Gavin, don't be embarrassed. Don't be embarrassed at all. I thought it was a beautiful picture. And Auntie comes up very well also. Now, team that played very well on the weekend in the qualifying final. They did a number on Port Adelaide, the Central District. They've been very, very good throughout the year, and their most creative player in the middle of the ground remains Rick McGowan.
The side's been performing on a consistent basis, but personally, I've had some good games, but there's been several very average games. Strength, it'd probably be reading and play. I need to be able to, because I don't have the athleticism of other players, that I have to keep ahead of the play. The good games that I have played, I've managed to get a bit of the football, and I guess if anything, that might attract a bit of attention.
Rick McGowan, and good luck to him for the rest of the count. Just a couple of little things that you may not know about the gentleman running us through the count tonight. Lee Wicker, the chief executive of the SANFL, has been doing it for a long time now, but going way back, he played 50 games for Sturt, and at age 24 was the general manager of the Sturt Football Club, and the man alongside him has been doing this job for 23 years. It's a long time. So back to the veterans, if I may, for the continuation of the count.
Thank you, Stephen. Round 9. Woodville West Torrens versus Glenelg. Eagles, Adam Pearce, 1 vote. Eagles, Gavin Colville, 2 votes. Eagles, Justin Sicilella, 3 votes. Norwood versus Port Adelaide. Norwood, Glenn Sanford, 1 vote. Norwood, Brett James, 2 votes. And Norwood, Damien Obst, 3 votes. Sturt versus West Adelaide. West Adelaide, Samuel Jones, 1 vote. West Adelaide, Daniel Donati, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Dion Miles, 3 votes. Central District versus North Adelaide. Central District, Marco Bello, 1 vote. Central District, Daniel Stevens, 2 votes. Central District, Rick McGowan, 3 votes. In round 10, South Adelaide versus West Adelaide. South Adelaide, Kim Cobb, 1 vote. West Adelaide, Christopher Chubb, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Benjamin Hollands, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Central District. Central District, Rick McGowan, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, David Brown, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, Michael Spanagel, 3 votes. Glenelg versus Norwood. Norwood, Robert Neal, 1 vote. Norwood, Jared Cotton, 2 votes. And Norwood, Glenn Sanford, 3 votes. North Adelaide versus Sturt. Sturt, Andrew Geddes, 1 vote. North Adelaide, Scott Sutherland, 2 votes, and Sturt, Tim Wetherill, 3 votes. In round 11, Sturt versus Central District. Central District, Brent Guerra, 1 vote. Sturt, Mark Conway, 2 votes. And Sturt, Stephen White, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Woodville West Torrens. Eagles, Andrew Rogers, 1 vote. Eagles, John Floriani, 2 votes. Eagles, Jamie Tate, 3 votes. North Adelaide versus South Adelaide. South Adelaide, Simon Crawshay, 1 vote. North Adelaide, Scott Sutherland, 2 votes. South Adelaide, Kim Costa, 3 votes. Norwood versus West Adelaide. Norwood, James Gallagher, 1 vote. Norwood, John Cunningham, 2 votes. And West Adelaide, Benjamin Hollands, 3 votes. In round 12, Central District versus Glenelg, Central District, Stuart Dew, 1 vote. Central District, Heath Hopwood, 2 votes. Central District, Daniel Healy, 3 votes. Woodville, West Torrens versus Norwood. Eagles, Christopher Kluzek, 1 vote. Eagles, Matthew Kluzek, 2 votes. Eagles, Kenneth McGregor, 3 votes. West Adelaide versus North Adelaide. West Adelaide, Paul Kouliaritis, 1 vote. West Adelaide, Chris Barrett, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Daniel Donati, 3 votes. South Adelaide versus Sturt. South Adelaide, Dean Talbot, 1 vote. Sturt, Matthew Powell, 2 votes. And South Adelaide, David Morgan, 3 votes. And that concludes round 12.
Labour work hard in the open goal. He's got it. The Iceman through. At the back of the field, it just needs a set point. Off the ground he goes, and he's got it. Oh, he's comes around on his right leg to Sue Atkinson, and he's drilled it. Big kick, Herbert. He's got a goal. Goes goal, and good. Right.
Line does not move.
There's another one to cook as he touches the air. Oh, that was very clever. That was very clever. Nice. Got it. It up and bang. Big kick there.
And Ricky O'Loughlin there. It's going to be pretty tough for Ricky to win it, having played 7 games throughout the year with the Adelaide Crows. Well, the last time consecutive medals were won, it was Gary McIntosh in that wonderful performance, 95 in the tie with Glenn Kilpatrick, out of his win in 1994. Of course, the only player who can achieve that tonight, his last year's winner, Damian Squire.
As a kid, I used to watch it all the time, you know. I used to follow it every year, and just I was so excited about when it used to come on. And just to be sitting there and have a medal around my own neck is just, it's unreal. I started kicking goals, and I started to become a half-forward flanker. And at North Adelaide, I mean, that's where they wanted me to play, and that was my role of the team then. Just, I had a run on the ball now and then, but I just didn't seem to fit in as well. But just to have a go on the ball at Sturt, it's just been great. I have, you know, a couple of years where I did struggle, and I just needed a change in life and a change of environment, and just to do what I've done and go to Sturt and just fit in so comfortably, it's just been great.
Magarey medalist drills it, and he likes it too.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Damian Squire. Could he come with a late run and win this year's Magarey medal? One of the medals we need to present tonight is the Reserves Magarey. With me is the 1965 Magarey medalist, Gary Window, who also won the 63 Reserves Magarey medal. Gary, must bring back great memories.
It certainly does. Great night, and good to see the Dogs up here again and going well this year. Only one thing I'd say to Max, though, how do I get Neil Curley to sit alongside? He's not a medalist.
Fair enough.
He's worthy of giving us a hard time.
Worthy of being here. Justin Cassley is the Reserves Magarey medalist from Central District. Put your hands together, please, for Justin. Justin, congratulations. You can add this Reserves Magarey to your 1992 Under-17 McCallum medal.
Yeah, well, I was lucky enough to win it in 1992, and
the other reserves. Magarey's very good, so happy with that.
Wonderful tradition at Central District for the Casserly family. Dad was a player and a coach. He'd be very proud.
Yeah, he's a great inspiration to me, Tony. Gives me a lot of advice, and perhaps he gives me a little bit too much sometimes. But
is there anyone you'd like to thank?
I'd like to thank, first of all, my family. Of course, Tony, my mother Margaret, who's my inspiration, the rest of my family, Natasha, Nathan and Vashti. Also the club, the officials, the stewards, the trainers for getting us out there on the park, everybody for their congratulations and that over the last week.
Well done. So, ladies and gentlemen, the Reserves Magarey medalist, Justin Casserly from Central District.
Well done, Justin. It wasn't just a win, by the way. Scored 28 votes to win it by 12. Okay, let's do an audit, shall we? Have a look at the leaders board after round 12. And we see that North Adelaide captain Scott Sutherland is just a slender leader over Gavin Colville, the 8-10 favourite on 9 votes. A few on 8, Jamie Tate, Brett Chalmers, who really raced away in the first few rounds. Rick McGowan, good to see him scoring some votes. And Clayton from Port Adelaide has 7 as well. Let's go back to the count now, rounds 13 to 18. Here's Max.
Round 13, West Adelaide versus Central District. West Adelaide, Matthew Toomey, 1 vote. Central District, Rick McGowan, 2 votes. Central District, Daniel Healy, 3 votes. Sturt versus Norwood. Sturt, Jared Twitt, 1 vote. Norwood, Matthew Dawes, 2 votes. Sturt, Bruce Lennon, 3 votes. South Adelaide versus Woodville West Torrens. Eagles, Kenneth McGregor, 1 vote. Eagles, Andrew Beveridge, 2 votes. Eagles, Jamie Tate, 3 votes. Glenelg versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Matthew Ashley, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, Daniel Morgan, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, Darren Fraser, 3 votes. Round 14, Woodville West Torrens versus Sturt. Sturt, Tim Wetherill, 1 vote. Sturt, Matthew Powell, 2 votes. Sturt, Damian Squire, 3 votes. North Adelaide versus Glenelg. Glenelg, Benjamin Moore, 1 vote. North Adelaide, Daniel Hargrave, 2 votes. North Adelaide, Benjamin Setchell, 3 votes. Central District versus South Adelaide. Central District, Chris Gowans, 1 vote. Central District, Sam McArdle, 2 votes. Central District, Marco Bello, 3 votes. West Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Stephen Carter, 1 vote. West Adelaide, Timothy Symes, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Daniel Donati, 3 votes. In round 15, Norwood versus Central District. Central District, Marco Bello, 1 vote. Norwood, Donald Dickey, 2 votes. Central District, Heath Hopwood, 3 votes. South Adelaide versus Glenelg. South Adelaide, Nathan Turvey, 1 vote. South Adelaide, Kim Cobb, 2 votes. And Glenelg, James Byrne, 3 votes. Woodville West Torrens versus North Adelaide. Eagles, Spiros Darsenis, 1 vote. Eagles, David Gallagher, 2 votes. Eagles, Andrew Beveridge, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Sturt. Sturt, Seamus Maloney, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, Matthew Ashley, 2 votes. Sturt, Bruce Lennon, 3 votes. In round 16, West Adelaide versus Norwood. West Adelaide, Dean Howard, 1 vote. West Adelaide, Christopher Chubb, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Benjamin Hollands, 3 votes. Glenelg versus Woodville West Torrens. Eagles, Darren Holland, 1 vote. Eagles, Andrew Beveridge, 2 votes. Eagles, Christopher Kluzek, 3 votes. South Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Brian Binkey, 1 vote. South Adelaide, Nathan Turvey, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, Alan Didak, 3 votes. North Adelaide versus Central District. Central District, Heath Hopwood, 1 vote. North Adelaide, Daniel Hargraves, 2 votes. North Adelaide, Lucas Herbert, 3 votes. Round 17, Port Adelaide versus North Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Philip McGuinness, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, Mark Clayton, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, Ricky O'Loughlin, 3 votes. Woodville, West Torrens versus West Adelaide. Eagles, John McCarthy, 2 votes. Eagles, Gavin Colville, 2 votes. And Eagles, Spiros Dazanos, 3 votes. Norwood versus South Adelaide. Norwood, Dale Fleming, 1 vote. Norwood, James Gallagher, 2 votes. And Norwood, Anthony Harvey, 3 votes. Sturt versus Glenelg. Sturt, Stephen White, 1 vote. Sturt, Jared Twitt, 2 votes. And Sturt, Tim Wetherill, 3 votes. North Adelaide versus South Adelaide in round 18. South Adelaide, Nathan Turvey, 1 vote. South Adelaide, Philip Merton, 2 votes. South Adelaide, John Hassell, 3 votes. Central District versus Woodville West Torrens. Eagles, John McCarthy, 1 vote. Eagles, Darren Holland, 2 votes. Eagles, Justin Sicilella, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus Norwood. Port Adelaide, Corey Archie, 1 vote. Norwood, Matthew Bors, 2 votes. And Norwood, Scott Bassett, 3 votes. West Adelaide versus Sturt. Sturt, Scott Robinson, 1 vote. West Adelaide, Benjamin Hollands, 2 votes. And Sturt, Damian Squire, 3 votes. And that completes round 18.
Out some bumps and bruises out of that lot, and I can tell you at the top of the leaderboard there are a few bumps and bruises up there as well. Our very clear favourite tonight's locked in a fierce battle at the top end with two of his teammates, with Jamie Tape and Andrew Beveridge, and this promises to be a very exciting count. There is the board, 11s all the way through. You've got Ben Hollands just tucked in there with 11, and Damian Squire, last year's winner as well, so it's going to be good. Speaking of our clear favourite, regardless of all that at the top end at the moment, he's had a wonderful year. He's had nearly 500 possessions, he won the Advertiser Award, and he's played in all 20 games. I'm talking, of course, of Gavin Colville.
The umpires will probably notice my red hair most of the time, and yeah, that's probably, in terms of voting, that's probably my best asset.
Stop the run. Can't stop. Best football, I think, would be on the ball somewhere, whether that's in the centre or a rover. I seem to get most of the football when I'm playing there. Probably my strength would be my running ability. I've got pretty good endurance. I like to work as hard as I can to get as many contests as I can. To win the Magarey, it's just a personal achievement. Very satisfying, but especially this year, I think a premiership win would be a little bit more satisfying.
He does get noticed, Gavin Colville. He had a top 10 finish in 1999, and I suspect that there's some fairly sweaty palms underneath the table there at the moment. Well, it's a perfect opportunity, isn't it, to go back to Michael Parsons. And Michael, with three of the local favourites there at Oval Avenue, we're slugging it out at the top. What's the mood like?
You can feel the tension starting to rise in the room. You can feel it, all right. Gavin Colville, still clearly the favourite and getting the biggest cheers, but I think they're saving a lot of cheers for anybody that gets up from the Eagles. But very clearly, the people are shuffling towards the end of the seats, and they just hope that a wee Eagles player gets up so they can give him a big cheer.
Thank you, Michael. Beautifully orchestrated, by the way. Time now for the presentation of the Ken Farmer Medal for the leading goal kicker in the minor round, and with David is a legend. Three-time winner of the Magarey Medal, Sturt's Len Fitzgerald.
Yes, 52, 54 and 59, Len. It was a great triple Magarey medalist, and here to present the Ken Farmer Medal to Adam Richardson from West Adelaide. Adam, congratulations. Another good year, three in a row for you.
Yep, no, it was terrific. So, no, a lot of effort to the boys and that sort of thing all year, so it's good.
You've been pretty consistent. I had a look at the record. 72, 66, 81 over the 3 years. There's not been much in it. You've played 40 out of a possible 42 games the last two seasons.
Yeah, no, it hasn't been too bad. Just with Wessies, we've got to win a few more games and play a few more finals games. That's what we all aim for. So, no, otherwise it's been pretty good.
And have you got anyone you'd like to thank?
Definitely. All the boys over there and all the boys back at the club and that sort of stuff. It's been terrific. Hard work all year up the ground to kick it down there. Dougie Thomas, Don McCaffrey at the West Adelaide Footy Club. Lee Harradine, Dr. Compton, Kim Davis, my better half, Shelley, my daughter Olivia. That's about it.
Well, and before you go, we've got one more presentation. Kevin Lyons, the state manager of SA for ANZAC, has got one more award for you.
Job's done. Good on you.
Adam, congratulations. On behalf of ANZAC, I'd like to present you with this award. It's $5,000 worth of travel-related services with ANZAC International and ANZAC Domestic Services.
Oh,
congratulations once again.
Good on you, Kevin. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Adam. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Adam Richardson, the Ken Farmer medalist.
Great effort, isn't it? 3 years in a row, the Ken Farmer medal, and Adam, obviously, a very, very accomplished full forward. Len Fitzgerald there too, by the way, a byline about him. Sturt have their Team of the Century dinner on September 9 here in the Convention Centre. And you were...
Eagles, Nicholas Pesch, 2 votes. Eagles, David Neiman, 3 votes. Glenelg versus West Adelaide. Glenelg, Matthew Golding, 1 vote. West Adelaide, Benjamin Watkins, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Daniel Donati, 3 votes. North Adelaide versus Norwood. Norwood, Benjamin Kemp, 1 vote. Norwood, Donald Dickey, 2 votes. Norwood, Andrew Pascoe, 3 votes. In round 20, Norwood versus Woodville West Torrens. Eagles, Andrew Beveridge, 1 vote. Eagles, Gavin Colville, 2 votes. Norwood, John Cunningham, 3 votes. Glenelg versus North Adelaide. North Adelaide, Scott Bamford, 1 vote. Glenelg, James Byrne, 2 votes. And Glenelg, Simon Hill, 3 votes. South Adelaide versus West Adelaide. South Adelaide, John Hassell, 1 vote. West Adelaide, Adam Richardson, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Benjamin Hollands, 3 votes. Central District versus Sturt. Sturt, Brodie Atkinson, 1 vote. Sturt, Tim Wetherill, 2 votes. And Sturt, Damian Squire, 3 votes. In round 21, Glenelg versus Norwood. Norwood, Justin Staritsky, 1 vote. Norwood, Damien Obst, 2 votes. And Glenelg, James Byrne, 3 votes. South Adelaide versus Central District. South Adelaide, Simon Crawshay, 1 vote. South Adelaide, Dean Talbot, 2 votes. And South Adelaide, Kim Cobb, 3 votes. Woodville West Torrens versus Port Adelaide. Eagles, David Gallagher, 1 vote. Eagles, Jamie Tate, 2 votes. Port Adelaide, Michael Spanagle, 3 votes. In round 22, Norwood versus Sturt. Sturt, Damian Squire, 1 vote. Sturt, Stephen White, 2 votes. Sturt, Tim Wetherill, 3 votes. Port Adelaide versus North Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Anthony Bamford, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, Alan Didak, 2 votes. And Port Adelaide, Philip McGuinness, 3 votes. West Adelaide versus Central District. Central District, Chris Gowans, 1 vote. Central District, Daniel Healy, 2 votes. And Central District, Rick McGowan, 3 votes. Glenelg versus South Adelaide. South Adelaide, Mark DeMarcy, 1 vote. South Adelaide, Michael Doughty, 2 votes. And South Adelaide, John Hassell, 3 votes. In the final round 23, West Adelaide versus Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, Paul Vines, 1 vote. Port Adelaide, Kane Acklin, 2 votes. West Adelaide, Adam Richardson, 3 votes. North Adelaide versus Woodville West Torrens. Eagles, Nicholas Pesch, 1 vote. Eagles, Gavin Colville, 2 votes. And Eagles, John McCarthy, 3 votes. Central District versus Glenelg. Central District, Chris Gowans, 1 vote. Central District, Damien Hicks, 2 votes. Central District, James Gowans, 3 votes. Sturt versus South Adelaide. South Adelaide, Philip Merton, 1 vote. Sturt, Brodie Atkinson, 2 votes. And Sturt, Damian Squire, 3 votes. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Magarey Medal for the year 2000 is Damian Squire of Sturt.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the most remarkable counts, I think, in living memory. Damien knows the routine. Would you please give Damian Squire, the year 2000 Magarey medalist, another huge round of applause.
Ladies and gentlemen, on your behalf, I extend to Damien congratulations on a marvellous performance. I think that's one of the most exciting counts that we've had for many, many years, and to win the medal once was certainly a fine achievement, but to win it a second time is a wonderful effort on your part. And on behalf of us all here, Damon, congratulations, well done, you're a very worthy recipient of this great award.
Now, as I said, you know the routine, so there's just one other little thing here, and this isn't too bad either. SA Lotteries have a presentation to you of $10,000. Would you please welcome in the room Chief Executive June Roach.
Damien, on behalf of SA Lotteries, congratulations. Well-deserved award, even though it's your second year in a row. But we're delighted in this first year that we're presenting this award that you've won it. And I have much pleasure in presenting to you a cheque for $10,000. Congratulations.
And it was a pretty big night for June too, by the way, back in 72, sister of Malcolm Blight. But at the moment, we've got more pressing matters. You know the routine. Self-appraisal. A better year in 2000 or in 1999?
No, definitely last year, I think. Yeah. I missed a few games this year through to injury, and I didn't think my form was the best throughout the whole year. So I definitely thought there was a few more better players in the competition. I mean, you've got Colvilles and your Ciccarellas and these sort of players, McGowans. At the moment, I'm just more nervous this year than what I was last year, I think.
To go back to last year, it was a bit similar, wasn't it, in that you were scored last year's 7 best on ground performances in the lead up to the finals, and it's a bit similar this year, a late charge. And I won't let you be so self-effacing. I saw you in 2 of the last 3 games in your best on ground, in my view. So the late surge.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the warmer weather when we've got it. I just don't know. I just didn't find the ball at this time of the year, which is really good.
And I remember speaking to you this same place, this same time, 12 months ago, and you just had a baby. She's now 1 and a bit.
Yeah, well, she's actually 11 months, because it's a little bit earlier than last year.
Sorry. I was never really very good at maths. But all that aside, I think you'd love to thank and pay tribute to an 11-month-old daughter and wives and clubs and so forth. So the stage is yours.
Definitely, I suppose I've got to thank the team to give me the opportunity to receive the second. It's fantastic. Also the footy club, but probably most of all is my family, my girlfriend Darlene, and of course my little girl Keely.
Well done. Well done indeed. What about a round of applause? And you might just keep that going, because spare a thought, young Gavin Colville came into tonight, the raging favourite. He carried that pressure all through the week. Can only imagine what sort of emotions he went through in the lead-up to tonight. He's been the runner-up, and he's had a wonderful year. So, Gavin, congratulations to you, and good luck in the finals. And for a wrap-up of all the leading vote-getters, let's go back to David.
Thank you, Stephen. Congratulations to Damian Squire. The winner, of course, Gavin Colville, who came in second, didn't win. Ben Hollands came in third from West Adelaide with 14 votes. Rick McGowan, who's polled so wonderfully well in recent years without winning, with 13. Jamie Tape at the Eagles with 13. Andrew Beveridge from the Eagles with 12. And Tim Retherold from Sturt with 12 votes. Great efforts from all of those players. As we go now to the leaderboard, we'll take you now to the club voting, starting with the Eagles, who did wonderfully well with 92. Central, 74. Port with 69 votes. Sturt, 67. 60 to South, 59 for Norwood, 56 for West Adelaide, North Adelaide were 33, and Glenelg were 30. So there's the club votes, Stephen, it's back to you.
Thank you very much, David. The perfect way to celebrate, with a few bubbles. Max.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please be upstanding while we toast the Magarey medalist of the year 2000, Damian Squire.
To Damian Squire.
Damian.
Well, I don't think the Sturt boys will be partying too much, because they have a very big game on the weekend, but there is a party to be had here at the Convention Centre tonight. Thank you for your company. That's our lot. Stay with the ABC through the finals series. Big semi-finals this weekend. 2 great games. I hope you can stay with the ABC for the last 3 weeks. For tonight, though, from Football Park, good night.